This episode has been brought to you by our super generous supporters on Patreon. At this point, you've heard of the fidget spinner, but if you haven't, good for you. But you might not have heard that it can purportedly help you learn better, concentrate, and focus. The Good Stuff producer Matt Weber looks into the supposed benefits of the fidget spinner and finds out whether or not they're as overhyped as the device itself. Take it away, Matt. Don't take away my fidget spinner, though. You actually can't. I don't own one.
Even though they were invented long, long ago in the 1990s, fidget spinners seem to pop out of nowhere. Try looking up Google searches for fidget spinner in 2016, and you'll see they are almost non-existent. Fast forward to now, and they are the top-selling item under toys and games on Amazon. It's the trendiest toy of its kind that we've seen in a long time. But is it just a toy? Various models purport a variety of benefits, including help with concentration, relief from anxiety, and even a reduction in the symptoms of autism. So if these fidget spinners are as beneficial as they say, why are they being banned in classrooms all across the United States? Can they really help your brain the way they say they can? First, let's examine why we fidget. Surprisingly, this is a hard thing to do because fidgeting behavior is largely unstudied. What we can say is that several studies have reported benefits in fidgeting behavior in cases where subjects suffer from ADHD, or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. ADHD is a brain disorder marked by an ongoing pattern of inattention or hyperactivity that interferes with functioning or learning. There is evidence that excess gross motor activity or hyperactivity is actually a mechanism that helps those with ADHD concentrate. This hyperactivity in early childhood is usually an indicator of ADHD, and until recently, fidgety or restless behavior has been viewed as an impediment to concentration and working memory. Working memory is the brain's ability to process information in the moment. The more efficient our brain's working memory is operating, the better we learn. In studies conducted where subjects with ADHD were allowed to engage in hyperactive behavior, their working memory visibly improved. That is, when they were allowed to fidget, they were better at learning. These studies proposed an interesting theory. Hyperactive tendencies are a way for people with ADHD to cope with their disorder and to concentrate better. That is, through fidgeting, you occupy the part of your brain that is driving you to distraction. Engaging in a mundane and thoughtless task, like tapping your foot or fidgeting with a paperclip, satisfies this need for diversion without actually distracting the part of your brain that is trying to pay attention, thus allowing you to concentrate. One largely accepted theory is that humans, ADHD prone or not, cannot devote 100% of their working memory to a single task. This actually has to do with the way our brains evolved. Imagine being a caveman. It wouldn't really behoove you to focus all your attention on bashing rocks together, as some giant beast could be lurking behind you, about to bite your head off. In other words, being constantly distracted is a survival technique. It keeps us alert and safe. We wouldn't want to get rid of it or turn it off, not entirely, but we would want to occupy it from time to time. If we really needed to concentrate on something, say building a fire, we wouldn't want to be constantly looking over our shoulder, letting our focus wander. So we occupy our hyperactive brain with some simple, thoughtless task, like tapping our foot. In other words, we fidget. Some have theorized this is a link between the use of motor skills and learning. A study done recently found that students absorb information better while taking notes by hand rather than using a laptop. And some fidget spinner companies have jumped on this study and used it as evidence that the use of motor skills enhances the learning process. And what could be better at utilizing your motor skills than a brand spanking new fidget spinner? But this motor skills lead to better learning theory is most likely wrong. What researchers did find is that while those students taking notes with a pencil and paper took far less notes than the students using laptops, the pencil and paper group were far better at understanding and conceptually applying the material being taught. However, much to the chagrin of fidget spinner distributors everywhere, researchers concluded that this wasn't because the students were using their hands or utilizing more of their motor functions. Instead, they reasoned that the pen and paper group had to process the information as it was being given to them so they could summarize it. Having to condense the material forced the students to absorb the information, and they were more likely to retain it. But the question remains, do fidget spinners actually help us learn? After all, there are benefits to fidgeting, and concentration is one of them. So could they help those with certain disorders learn better? The answer is probably not. While fidgeting may help people with certain disorders and may be an evolutionary necessity in the general population, you're probably much better off with a pencil or tapping your foot than a fidget spinner. The thing is, in almost every study that touts the benefits of what we define as fidgeting, that fidgeting behavior is nowhere near as complicated as the operation of a fidget spinner. While a fidget spinner might seem pretty simple, it requires hand-eye coordination, which means it's a visual distraction. You have to balance it, you have to hold on to it, and you have to keep it spinning. Ultimately, this demands too much of your attention, and you are distracted from what you're actually trying to pay attention to. Remember, the whole theory behind the benefits of fidgeting depends on being able to free up your brain so you can focus on a subject and learn. If you have to consciously think about the fidgeting, then all the benefits are lost. So next time you're about to click on and buy that 2017 Titanium Alloy Triangle Rainbow Fidget Spinner, you might as well just get some pencils and paper, or just a rock or something.
So, what do you think? Do you have any special fidgeting techniques or advice to give? Do you use fidget spinners yourself to enhance your working memory? Let us know in the comments. And use that working memory, and don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video if, in fact, you enjoyed it. Special thanks to our Patreon subscribers for making this episode of The Good Stuff possible. Without Patreon, this show just wouldn't happen. So if you'd like it to continue like a perpetual fidget spinner, my nickname in high school, head on over to our Patreon page and support the show. Thanks for watching.